23rd March 2020, a day that will be seared in our memories forever, the day the world as we knew it changed, the day Sushila Birla Girls School had to shut its gates to its students, teachers, staff, and all those who made it a thriving, nurturing, dynamic environment. In the months that followed, our beautiful school turned into a ghost campus. Empty rooms and corridors. No children, no laughter, no joy. Everything was silent. And in these months, we experienced great fear, anxiety, difficulties, and even great loss. However, the new year has brought with it new hope, and we are looking forward to making a new beginning. Looking forward to welcoming our students back to school. Looking forward to some joy and laughter, to some semblance of normalcy.
Good morning from the entire SPGS family. It gives me immense pleasure to be able to welcome you back home, home where you truly belong. In this video, let me now take you through the measures that we have put in place to ensure that you and all of us remain safe in school. Let us begin right at the beginning, that is the school gate. We have now come to our school gate. We will be using two of our school gates for entry as well as for exit. These will be class specific and they will be opened half an hour before classes begin in the morning. Now let's take a look at the footpath. You can see that we have put footprints over here. These are to ensure that social distancing norms are followed very careful. To my left and to my right, you can see the security guards at the gate will be equipped with a thermal scanner, which they will use to check the temperature of all those who are entering through the school gates. And our security guards themselves will be wearing a shield as well as a mask. No entry inside school without a mask or a shield. And when I refer to a mask, I mean a 3-ply mask in a solid color, preferably black or navy blue. Now let's take a walk inside. You can see that we've put queue managers here. This will mean that students, teachers, faculty members, everybody, there'll be two queues, which means that social distancing norms will be followed. You can see the footprints here as well. And to my left and to my right, there are these touchless sanitizer dispensing machines. We have attendants here who will monitor and see that everybody who walks through will sanitize their hands first and then move ahead. Now we are in the main building. Let me take you through the main entrance. This is the staircase, and this is what the children will use to go up to their classes. Children are not going to be using the lift, and that we will reserve only for emergencies. You see, there are certain surfaces which require constant cleaning because they get contaminated very fast. The railing, the handrail, these will be cleaned regularly at frequent intervals. All across the school, we have digital display boards where the information that you see on the signages are going to be displayed. This will help to create awareness as well as remind people that they need to follow all the norms. We have placed sanitizer dispensing machines on all the landings. Students, as they come up, before they enter the classroom, they will sanitize their hands and then move inside. As you can see, we are covered by CCTV cameras and we are constantly under surveillance. Now we are inside the classroom. Now I'd like to point out something that's very interesting, the seating arrangement. You can see that every second desk has been crossed out. As a result, we have created a zigzag pattern, which means that we will be able to follow social distancing norms in the classroom. Right here, you can see some paraphernalia. We will expect that all our girls, all our students, they will have their own bottle of sanitizer. They'll be wearing a mask and a shield and also a disposable bag, which they can use to keep their soiled mask. Teachers will be taking class in well-equipped classrooms in their protective gear. Over here we have Mrs. S. Chatterjee, who is our middle school coordinator and an English expert herself. We have some big rooms with appropriate furniture in the primary building. Those rooms will also be used for our senior students to ensure that they are spaced out. We are now in the physics lab. Let me take you through this lab. You will again see these red crosses. These are the workstations. The number of students at each workstation is now only 2. Students will be brought in very, very small groups to all the laboratories, and they will work under the guidance of a teacher at all times. Right here in the physics laboratory, we have our science HOD, Mrs. S. Sarkar, who is a physics teacher herself. All the norms that are being followed in this particular lab will be followed in all the other labs. Senior students, even though they do not have a library period, will be able to use the facilities of our school library. And after that, all the protocol regarding hygiene will be followed. We have now come to probably the most important room in the entire school. That's the isolation room. In the course of the day, it might happen that a student, teacher, faculty member, staff member might develop temperature or show some symptom. In that case, that particular person will be brought to this well-equipped isolation room and kept completely isolated over here. Of course, we have a nurse here who's attired with a complete PPE kit, and a very high level of sanitization and hygiene will also be maintained over here. The person will be kept isolated till the point that a member of his or her family comes and takes him away. Our regular infirmary will also be functional, but over there we will address minor issues like cuts and bruises, and of course that infirmary will be far removed from the isolation room. Sanitization and hygiene, two very important words in our lives right now. All rooms are going to be fumigated at the end of the day and then locked securely, and all open areas will be sprayed with a disinfectant.
I would like to introduce to all our viewers another member of our family, Mr. Jagrit Chaudhary. Jagrit, warm welcome.
Thank you.
He's part and parcel of SBGS, and of course both his daughters are with us. So Jagrit, how did you like the tour around the school?
Oh, it was very, very reassuring. You know, the kind of precautions you guys are taking to make sure that it's a safe environment. It's really reassuring.
Thank you.
Though I still have a few more questions.
Of course. Fire away.
So, the first thing is, if you think of the recess, children really want to come out, party together. So how do you manage the canteen, the children at that time?
Actually, see, this pandemic has changed our lives completely. So all aspects of it. So break time also will now look a little different. We are going to insist that children carry their tiffin boxes and their water bottle with them, which means that during break, they should be in the classroom. Of course, they will be monitored. There'll be somebody in class. And this will, I think, reduce the crowds. Unnecessary trips up and down the staircase will be out. In addition, the canteen will also be closed.
But what about the trips to the washroom? The other one?
Yes, there also, social distancing norms will be followed. Attendants will be there on duty. The taps in between will be crossed out. And of course, we've put in plenty of soap dispensers, so that should help.
Okay. Just one question. Children are right now studying at home. There are 4 walls, coming back to the classroom, not allowed to move around much, 4 walls. Any kind of physical activity?
Of course. That's part of our plan. Again, monitored. Monitoring will happen round the clock. But one thing that we need to keep in mind is that any kind of sport which involves group contact, that we have to avoid.
So you're saying no basketball?
No basketball, but maybe yoga.
Okay. And what if, be it a teacher, be it a student, be it any other staff member, someone in their family tests positive? What do you do then?
In that case, the student will definitely have to take leave for the entire period and also follow all the norms of the quarantine period. That is the only way in which she will be able to keep herself safe and the others as well.
God forbid, if a student or a teacher at school tests positive, what happens then?
Now, in this particular situation, if a student or a teacher, they go home and then they test positive, what are we going to do? Of course, the person concerned needs to quarantine herself, that goes for sure. But the tricky part is, how wide will the circle of quarantine be? That's the gray area. Now, as far as this is concerned, I think we need to wait for a little while to get some clear directives from the state government, because even as we speak, the situation is changing. So I think right now we need to wait for some time for some more directives from the state government.
So one last question. What about dispersal? Because that again is quite chaotic typically.
Yes, that's part of our plan. See, dispersal will happen like entry. You know, like we mentioned, that entry will be through two gates, dispersal also through those two gates. It will be class specific, and also children will not be released from their classes all at the same time.
Okay, so they're staggered.
Staggered into queues. So I think there should not be any kind of a problem at that point of time.
Sure. Okay, sounds good.
Thank you, Jack.
The time has come for us to hear your laughter and to see your smiling faces. School is just not the same without you. You complete us. I would like to end with a hope and with a prayer that we will meet soon. Bye-bye and good luck.